A group of teenagers from the North Coast has launched its own mini version of the global Me Too movement by speaking out about sexual harassment in Northern Ireland.
With the help of Fixers, the campaign that gives young people a voice, they hope to turn their personal experiences into a force for change.
Last summer, I was out with my friend and she was away getting a drink, so I was by myself. And someone came over to me and kind of physically backed me into a corner so I couldn't leave. Because no one was around, no one could like help me get away from the situation, and I felt really like trapped and it was really scary.
This like 30-something old man said this like really offensive, derogatory term. Molly had said that he had actually like been grabbing other people as well. It wasn't like it was on the arm or anything, it was like in places you wouldn't want to be grabbed by anyone.
It doesn't even happen just on nights out as well. When I like walk home from work, there's people in their cars and they're shouting out the window and stuff. It makes me feel so like uncomfortable and embarrassed almost.
We don't want this to be a normal experience. We should be able to go out and have fun without the fear that someone thinks they can intimidate girls like that.
My name is Lucy McDowell.
My name is Kristen Probst.
We are both 18 years old and we are part of a group of girls from the North Coast in Portstewart and Portrush. Our Fixer project is highlighting the concerns of being on a night out and hearing derogatory terms or getting comments that make you feel uncomfortable or being grabbed or touched in ways that you know it's not right and makes you just feel unsafe.
If someone comes into your own personal space or makes an offensive comment towards you, it's not something that you've really went out to experience on a night out.
It makes you feel so small and feel so intimidated in an environment that should be safe and should be where you should be having fun.
Increasingly, we understand that trauma can be very individually defined. So it can be a distressing event that exhausts a young person's ability to cope with it. So if somebody experiences an infringement of their personal space like that and they feel that they can't cope with that, then that could constitute a trauma and it could lead to secondary emotional problems like depression or post-traumatic stress.
We're going to create a film that basically highlights harassment in young adults. We hope that it encourages other young adults to come forward.
It shouldn't be normal for someone to be saying derogatory things to you, for someone to be touching you in places you don't want to be touched.
Seeing our own friends in those situations and thinking to ourselves, we've also been in those situations, and it's not something that we can all take lightheartedly, and it's time for us to fight back and say something.
Our latest report from Fixers.